the middle of Queen Charlotte Strait. Just heading over the crew boat. Nice, clear, calm, placid day. Going up Knockwacko Rapids here shortly. Step outside here for a few minutes, shoot a quick video. Fort Hardy back in behind us there. Tremble Island, I got her on camera, right there. Nakwacto Rapids right there, boys and girls.
Hey, this is the John Houghton wood lot.
Right here, this is where we're going, right across the road. Welcome to Mirrorworth Sound. That's where we're going. Nice wood in here, man. Absolutely beautiful in here. Doesn't get any nicer water. Just gorgeous. April 9th, 2012. I think it's the 10th today, I can't remember. Stuff just awesome. Home sweet home, here we are. Right up in the head of Mirrorworth. We're about a 10-minute boat ride from that last video. And that's where we're putting in at. Got road in there. Their camp, Margaret's Deeds. Well, it's a beautiful day in Mirrorworth Sound. Sun's shining today, absolutely gorgeous. April 11th, 2012. Here's our weapon of choice here. ZX350 LC-2. And it's aged to about 8,500 hours. No, this is a 10,000 hour machine, this one here. Just runs great, nice machine. Perfect day to cream some old growth rainforest on the coast of BC. This is the Georgian Bay project. We're about 5K in from the beach now. They've built in from the beach. I'm on subgrade up ahead. We've got the ZX240 about half a K behind me there. Just drilling a quick quarry. Some of the wood that we're getting into here. It's actually kind of shitty stuff. We're getting up into some really nice stuff as we work up and around the corner here. 7-8 foot cedars. So this is a BC Timber Sales job. Jumped in over top of a S6 creek right in here earlier today. Got in and across in here, and I'll get this wood out of the way in here next. Don't have much time to go and film anything here right now. It's just basically hammer down. The only way to do it, timber sales. But yeah, this is, we're gonna be hooking into the switchback up and above us in here. And there's only about 450 meters of road left to build. And then we've got to go and put in a 9.1 meter SureSpan modular bridge up at the top for the termination of the contract. So this is where we're working right now. And probably the nicest excavator I've spent time on here. I can't believe the power this thing's got. It's just incredible. I would say it keeps up to my dad's old 235C in every bucket for power, swing for swing. It's just incredible. So, got a danger tree right in there. Gotta knock him out. There's our puncheon down in the back corner. Machine's solid all the way around. No dents or dings, just the regular sort of mud and scratches on it, but just, man, oh man, what a machine. So anyway, there it is. Going back to work here now. I have to slip and fall on my arse in here. This was fell and bucked about 2 weeks ago, so we're working our way up into the meat of it now. And there's some really nice trees up in the top end here. So there it is. That's what we're doing today. So, gonna wreak some more havoc here. Okay, well, this is another video. Well, putting your balls on it. Had a good one there from Island Fiber there last Christmas. Just another good one in here. Got a bunch of tow rock right in here.
Just getting into what's called transition area here, changing out from overlanding behind me here where I punched my way up the hill, drained it out on the low side, and then here on the right side here, I've got a creek that's coming up in here on the right. But I just finished slabbing out about an 8-foot log here, but I needed to do it, I needed the wood. But yeah, there's no such thing as shortcuts in here. Holy crap, I'll be over the edge right here. Start moving around here without this wood, and you can feel everything moving in here. It's good, I had the bosses up here a few minutes ago. They looked at it, they were happy. They don't mind me asking advice, which is good because we don't want to die. Because this, I wouldn't go and roll the hoe or nothing here, but we'd have a mess. The hoe would be all bound up in the trees down below. Let's just not think like that. But yeah, we're chasing the edge of the mountain in here now. Walking ahead. That was my center line there, is my pink. So, yeah, pretty good little photo right there. Coming up into some pretty virgin territory here now. I think last time this was, had no trees here, it was the dawn of time. But yeah, that's where we're shooting for our center line right up here. And I'm gonna start chasing my toe rock along the edge in here. Probably have a heading shot coming forward in here now. So yeah, we're getting into the down and dirty now. But yeah, you don't set yourself up, I'd be over the bank by now. All that water coming out of the bank in here. Holy crap. But yeah, that's good. It's enjoyable. A little bit different than processing beetle kill pine in Prince George. So we've got another center line right in there, so I'll hike myself up there. It's a little on the right. See where I can chase the mountain, and I'll go and beetle my way up along here. By beetling my way up, I mean I'll probably be up by that stump here in a couple hours. Thought about going and putting the camera on the suction cup here, but really, I just gotta focus on what's going on here or I'm dead, man. It's good. Finally get to earn a paycheck here. So yeah, there's some pretty nice wood in here. Probably the nicest log was that one I went and slabbed out there about 10 minutes ago. Anyway, we're in here to go and get the road in, not log the wood. See right down in there, that's what I don't want, so I gotta get something happening with that. Get that draining. Okay, I gotta go to work here. This got some water control issues here now, and this is not serious. Well, this is where we're at, right about there, just past that drainage. Let's look at my work here. We're 6 o'clock, April the 12th. On our way up into here now. Starting to get into out of this some pretty significant side cast. There's that creek right here that comes up on the map. So, let's get into some nice, pretty large chunk of yellow cedar. And, I don't know, by the time I started eyeing on it there, I guess it was about 4 foot at the butt. Just kept paring it down. What's left of it right in here started to get pretty knotty. Managed to go and score and get some glacial till in here that I could pull. Gotta tidy up my ditch in here a little bit in the morning. A little drain for overnight here anyway, I'm not gonna lose the road. So, starting about, I would say about 3 feet in from the center line. That's it. Right up in there. So I'm actually in here a little bit, but it jogs out as I'm working my way up into there, so that's okay. I'll cut the corner a little bit here. Be okay. Just take a look at my station here. And it's TP 82. So reference that to the map and I'll put me where I'm at. It was a good day today. Got a little dicey down there at that drainage. Started getting into that toe rock, it's called transition area. you don't go and control your water, you'll lose hoe right over the bank. So we got that all under control. Ran good today, the machine. And what a warhorse those 350s axis machines are. Holy smokes. Okay, so there it is. So we'll get our way down. And I hiked all the way up around here with about 20% grade by the time I got up and around this corner here. Quite a bit of cut in here. Oh, yew tree. Most people like to make their roads out of gravel and rock. I like to add in 1,200-year-old trees. So. Yeah, so there's completed subgrade. And they're actually off to the left right there. Is a spur down there, GB 10,070. So that's not part of this contract. But we're actually in the block here now. So all this is slated to come down here. And there is a bit of a riparian that's down in there, about 300 meters. But yeah, this will definitely drain here for the night. I'll have to go and fire this ditch line out of here. But yeah, there it is. Good. Don't like that. One little divey corner right about there. Don't like that, but it's going down to the ditch. I might wood that up some more. Big chunks in here, but I'll tell you, they should lock into place. That's what you need. So. Start working our way out, bit of blast here for 6:30 here, so catch up with that here in a few minutes. Just walking out here. Gonna fire the blast here in a minute. Here's our two other machines here. On the right, that's our ZX240 LC-3 excavator drill. Coastal drilling compressor unit. Over on the left hand side is an EX370 LC-5 high cap. My bosses are over there, so I'd probably kill the camera. Okay. Quick video here. It's our driller, Dana, there that's running the excavator, so that's why it's kind of slow. Not too good of a hoe operator there, but he's running the excavator while we're not drilling today. Swamper Cody there is on the rock truck. Ballasting down to right here. I'm spreading, just doing a quick little end haul. That up there is an EX370-5 Apache, old Weyerhaeuser unit. The high cap, which makes it real nice for in the pits. It's April 13th, 2012. About 11 o'clock, 11:30 in the morning here. Down he comes, so I'm gonna have to kill the video here pretty quick. See what I'm doing here. Got a bridge behind me here. It's filling in one spot here. Where hasn't been ballasted yet. I'm gonna start going the other way. April 14th. We're gonna shoot a quick video before I head off to work here this morning. Looking down Mirrorworth Sound. And that's up towards the head of it up there, past a point. And this is known as, this is actually the old Interfor Mirrorworth camp. Log dump right here. So site 3, I don't know the name of the creek in here, but the road goes up right up into the bush, way up in there. Old Interfor pickups. There's our float camp, it's over there, and right on the other end of it there, there's a small 4 or 5 bedroom house on a barge there that belongs to Interfor. But yeah, that's our float camp. keep our hydraulic press and bolts and what have you in there. Generator here for powering up our side of the camp. Couple of relics here, left over here from the 3 or 4 days. Moses and Jenny Inlet. Geez, who knows how many years this little beater's been in here. Looks like an old GLM falling truck here. Would be the right colors for the GLM truck. And it's been sitting here for a long, long time as well, it looks like. Anyway, this is the main line, and it's supposed to go back into the bush here. Long, long way. It's the old Muirworth main. So, here's where we're out of. We're gonna walk down to the dock here in a minute. Just wanna show everyone here how my day begins. So, this is looking over from the Interfor side. Their float house in here. That's their generator they got going in there. So, their boat. It's called the Rough One. Our boat there. We got the Rough Two as well. There's a Rough Three also. That's where we're going, about 10K down that inlet. So that's the story.
Can drive,
John. Am I the chauffeur today?
Yeah,
okay.
I'm going to jump out at the mag there.
Okay, sounds good. I can do that. No problem. I'll have to go up the hill this morning. Hey, is that a fire extinguisher that we're supposed to pick up here on the beach? Well, here's what we're building for completed road in here. Showing here what we've got. And where we're going. Got a 1,000 mil culvert coming up here. Another 150 feet. I don't think I'll have enough rock in the pit to go and get into that yet. Let's do another blast. Oh, here comes Cody, back up the hill here. Oh, pardon me, little yawn. I guess we're doing something right here. Learned a new ballasting technique there from my boss yesterday about maximizing fines, and that went good. Oh yeah, here he goes, he's gonna back off the road here on me. Nope. Not. Oh yeah, he dipped her down there pretty good. Nice work. Green kid on the truck here. Nice guy, Cody from Campbell River. Anyway, get back on the machine here. Okay, so was there 14th today, April 14th. I guess we're developing it into a quarry here now. There's actually another spur that cuts off over in here. It's not on our contract, but it's going to be going in behind these pipes and put a short little spur into there, so a landing in there so they can yard up into it. But we're going to go and nuke the floor out of this one today. You can see here it's pretty sloppy looking rock. It blasts out okay. Anyway, I'm gonna go and build a ramp in here and get some boulders tossed over to the right hand side. I've developed some more over in here. Thinking I'm probably gonna have to get a trail up top here. Get the fallers back in and dump over some of these trees. We'll see how we stand for rock here. See what this makes here for material. End of the road's just up in there. Getting into a little bit of glacial till down in the bottom corner there, but I've stripped some more off. Nuked a few trees and threw them over the bank here a little while ago. So, that's our game plan. I'll get some of these rocks thrown out of the way. The machine over there. And ramp down into there so we can start drilling some pattern. And then thinking we can reach up on top of that bluff there with the hoe drill. Go and downhole it, at least far back as it stumps. So yeah, that's what we're doing in here right now. So this will be vaporized by 7 o'clock tonight. So that's the story. Gotta go and grab a couple of these 1,000 pipes here. I think there's two out of the back that are beat up. They're packed about 20 times to get up where we're at. So far up in the bush in here now. Powder truck right over there. So yeah, you can see some of the debris has been tossed out here by the last two blasts. I'd like to video them there, but it's the last thing we do before we head down the hill at night here is go and shoot a shot. So it's really not too practical to go and video them. But there is another road that winds its way down right in the bottom, about 3K down. We were getting stuff on down there. So I'm sure there are some pretty good videos here when this gets broken out, being an open face shot. But yeah, okay, anyway, I'm gonna go back to work here now, throw some rocks off to the side, but that's the story, and that's what we're doing. Okay, so here's the job at the moment that we're gonna do here now. Moved up to the road heading here. You can see right there where it's terminated. And we're gonna make some rock out of this in here. We've got ourselves a creek. It's coming out of the side in here, but it's not an S6 stream, so we are allowed to blast it, so we're gonna blow the shit out of this little stream right in here. You can see it coming out of the bank. Right there. So the first thing I gotta go and do is push over that cedar tree that's in here and start exposing some rock, get this mud dealt with. So I'm just up here by myself right now here. Everyone else put a click behind me right now, so it's okay. I got some time to go and video this, so make some good rock here, go into the bank for it. See some yellow cedar here that are all chunked out. Well, that's good. It's a nice day here, good time to shoot a little video. So that's what we're gonna go and do, is we're gonna take out that tree and go in for some rock here, strip it off. So got this big old cedar stump here, perfect place for the camera. So I think that's where I'll set it up. Yeah. Okay, so give it a few minutes there and let it film. And there you can see what we're gonna do.
Right on.
I hope that video turned out okay. Too serious there. Showing another day at work, what I do. Destroying the rainforest. Okay. Yeah. Oh yeah, I'll work my way up into there, start opening my ditch up after I pull down some more material. Going off that glacial till, I think, next too, and make some good material. But yeah, this rock couldn't come at a better time. We need it here for this hill, so this is what I went and built the other day to get up into here. A lot worse than what it actually appears when I started coming up into here, I can say that. Anyway, we're in. Starting to be some pretty good going up ahead here. Going to be some full bench. Well, I shouldn't say that. Pretty three-quarter bench side cast here coming up. So, okay. Off we go. So, here's about 20 minutes later. Nuked out that pretty quick. This is what you really got to be careful of in here. It's what's called a transition area. Where it transitions here from your dirt, subsoil, mineral soils into your solid rock, and you can see where it takes off like that. And I got my subgrade built up into here. If you don't control your water, it'll go and undermine underneath and saturate it. Then everything goes and starts to slide down the hill like that, and that's real roll by excavator. It's really crucial that you do water control in here, so I've ditched it down good and deep in here without pulling the punch, and it looks a little sloppy along the edge in here, but you need the depth to get your ditch. I'm gonna come down into here next, smear out the bottom of this ditch. So I'm just working my way up into this glacial till here now. But yeah, this is really, really important here. Like, this is how guys die when they don't go and control their water. Oh, very expensive machine as well. So we're looking okay here right now. I'll just keep working my way in. Keep working this edge, smear out this material over into here, dig it out. You gotta be real careful here. It's not just scoop and bail here by any stretch. It's just get your bucket in, just work it and work it and work it. Cast it right out, get it right out of the grade, because you can't be having this contamination along the edge here. This is okay in here. I can wood this all up, but you know, you just want these big balls of mud to get out of the grade. And when we do go and fire this, it'll all go and lay over. And then I can ramp up and go in after some more rock into there. I'll go and knock out the four or five smaller trees. Then we'll have a decent quarry here. Between the quarry that's down the hill and this one here, the two should match up pretty quick here on rock sources. So anyway, yeah, just wanted to show you here. There's a little bit of method to the destruction here, what we're doing. But yeah, this is what we got to do here to get the road up and in. I'm up good and stable. That's why we need the wood here to get yourself up and stable. We'll handle here. 90,000 pound excavator. So anyway, that's what we're doing. Tried pulling on that rotten old cedar there. He's pretty well hung up there still, so I think I'll just leave him up there. Don't want to go and pull down everything else up on the bank. I see trees wiggling and moving. That one that runs across right there, he's all moving, as well as that deadfall. So I'll have all that on top of me here if I don't watch what I'm doing. So I think we'll working along this edge in here. Okay. Well, we picked ourselves up a little bit of a score here with this glacial till, that's for sure. It's something in here for the hoe drill to sit on. It's nice and stable. Just scattered it over top of the punch in here. Now I can climb up here, not slide down the hill with the street pads. It's like we're chasing rock all the way up. So that's a good thing. So I think we weren't anticipating getting this rock, and that's definitely a bonus. We're looking pretty good here right now. Things all draining down below. Looking pretty good. Almost knows, looks like I know what I'm doing here. I won't tell anybody. So yeah, there's the creek. And yeah, there it is. Well drained. Everything down below the subgrade. I think we're gonna be okay. And if I have to, I'll throw in a little bit more cedar down into the bottom down in there. Open it up down that one side there, but the water definitely moving. So Yes, I think we're looking good. Gonna have a quick sandwich here, sun's shining. Get up here and build some more road. Excellent.
Well, it's my first time trying this. I'm up here by myself, so better way to try it out right now. So yeah, here we go. Pay attention more to what's going on in the camera, so if it falls down, forgive me. There on the camera, whatever. Anyway, just bear with it. We're getting some better going in here now. Set my wood aside, I'll be keeping that for my road in a little while. Stuff like this, you need to have a breakout. Walk ahead here a little bit. Standing her up on her toes in here, just wait for that log. Undercarriage stood off on a couple of cedar logs here to give myself an advantage. Go under here, I'll throw my bucket under here, that can break out of the bank. He's got right there. Bust this all out. Oh yeah, out you come, baby. There we go. Yellow cedar here. Some money right there. Why would we buy $350? Thank you. stump back in there, I see. Clean this stick off the top. Stump out of there, we're just grabbing one side. I can't believe the power of the 350's got, man. Yeah, it's coming with me, it's over. My stump. Off of him here. Maybe we'll grab him just like this. Oh shit, look at the power this thing's got, man. Over the edge she goes. Gone. Split into twice, two pieces it looks like. Get all this stuff down nice and low. Take that other stump I was talking about. I'll use him to hold my road there. See how well he's held. I think I'll leave him right there. Already changing the face of things here now. Apprehensive of people watching this video here. Oh, you should be doing this, you should be doing that. Well, it's the way I'm doing it. I think you're standing right here where they're supposed to be.
nice and not raining. But a lot more sketchy when the rain comes down. Muddier, messier. More unstable. Thank you. pain for this stuff. That's okay, we're gonna make it work today.
Dead dinosaur looks like. This will be the last video, I guess, here. My battery's about to die. Do a pump pressure line here on the last day of work. We're just getting a hose pressed up in camp.